What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Tony D2 Wild checking in once again, man. Back at it like a motherfucking crack addict, man. Today with a very special vid. If you are a part of the notification squad, let it be known down in the comment section. I want to start shouting you guys out, the people that comment, let you guys know. Give out like the first 10 people every comment, first 10, first 20, I don't know, just throughout the video. I don't know. I want to say salute to everybody out there that hits that bell. And this shows major support. One thing about this apartment now that I realize that I hate, and I'm like I said, guys, I'm moving. I signed my lease. It's done. But this place, it sucks at fucking lighting, bro. We got a light right here. So right here is pretty good. But if you shoot right here, you got that light in the back that's fucking things up. Then you shoot over here, you got that. It's all fucking washed out in the back. Now if I shoot right here, I got this weird ass light up here that causes like a dick to pop up in my fucking mouth. Look, there's a, you see the dick right here? It's in my mouth. Then we got a set of lights right here that, I don't know, it's just, then you got like the sun ray effect. Like there's nowhere in here that's just a good lighting area, really except for the front. So this is why I usually start right here. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like that's just, I don't know, this is, I hate that shit. But anyways, guys, today is pretty much, in the next couple days, it's gonna be pretty much really, really lame as fuck. The car is officially taken. We gotta go outside and pick up some packages from the pending parcel. Hold on. And as you can see, this motherfucker's flying right here. Slow your head down, lady. As you can see, they moved everybody's car. That lady slowed the fuck down once she saw it was recorded. My car's gone. They towed it yesterday. So it's over and done. And a lot of you guys may have been wondering, like, why are you moving? Like, why are you being scared of moving? Like, I'm not scared of moving. That's not the case. I just got the opportunity to break my lease. It's either that or stay here for another 8 months. And it's like, I like it here. It's cool. But I'm always the guy that likes to move around and stuff. Even when it is, like, I like to buy cars. I might buy a house and then want to sell the house in a year. It's just how I am. I can't stay in one place. Now, that's why buying a house at the same time is a scary commitment, because once I buy it, you know, that's something that you stay in, you know, you stay in with for 30 something years. So it's a lot of thought process going on into it. But they gave me the opportunity to break a lease and just try something new, go somewhere new. When I first moved in here and now, a lot has changed in a good way. So that's one of the reasons why I'm ready to just move on to something better, move on up. So this thing is called a parcel pending. Basically they drop the packages off right here. I'm trying to see. Oh shit, one right here. Right here. So you're gonna put this big ass box and this small one, but then this baby ass box and this big ass one. What kind of backward shit is that? One thing I haven't been able to touch too much on was I got a cat. This is my cat of 18 years. She's 18 years old, and she's been living with my mom, and I finally moved her here. When I moved her, you know, my grandfather had passed, who had passed away, was like the main person she's always around. I'm the one that found her. I found her when I was 8 years old. I'm 26, do the math. But she was like, they were taking care of her at my mom's house, but they weren't like spending time with her and stuff. And she would just sit in the room all day, just lay there and eat. I brought her here. She was first day kind of shaky. But then ever since, she kind of was like, just been straight. I had her on this right here, just eating. And I had to stop because she was eating too fucking much. Now I got to like portion it. If you guys know how much to feed a cat, I've been looking up on the internet and I keep looking. But if you know how to feed a cat, let me know, because I don't want her to starve. I want her to get fat, but I don't want to get too fat, obese, nothing like that. I just want to get her a little bit. She was like skinny because they'd feed her, but the dogs eat the food, and it just, I'm trying to get it right, and I don't know. Hold on. You good? See, look, see, I can't shoot here because of this shit. Like, that's what I'm saying. I hate it. There's nowhere to shoot. You can't shoot anywhere in this fucking house. All right, that's why I got to do everything at an angle. I can't just shoot dead on with you guys like this. Anyways, I picked something up the day of the whole car incident, and I wanted to go ahead and play that clip, because I didn't want to keep the clip like all in one day, because I've been basically uploading a video that was shot days ago. So let's just go ahead and switch over to that day and see the pickup that I got. Huge shout out to One Legged Lister. And when we get back, we can check out what we got here, man. Let's get it. So Lister showing me some new kicks. What are these right here? These Paul Georges. What are these?
Paul George, EYBLs.
Volleyball?
Yeah, the basketball
like,
league thing.
Okay. Yeah, because I've seen like KD had these or something, right?
Yeah, everybody had a pair.
Yeah. But I remember he's been having a pair for a minute now, though.
That pair right there, man. I've been wanting to get a hold of that pair. They're going like seven.
These are
going
to be on the channel when? On your channel?
Yeah, I'm not so much worried about my channel.
You ain't got to show it. I'm just saying. Yeah, no. These are something that you guys will check out. He'll post on his channel
Monday.
On Monday. I don't even want to ruin it for you.
That's my kid's sitting there.
And then we got these. You said these are Academy?
I mean, it's just like the EYBL. It's just like another basketball league.
Okay.
Yeah, you see there on the hill, they got that little
tab. These are dope too. Nice olive color. So guys, man, let's see here what your boy Lister hooked it up for your boy with, man. Let's check this out real quick. Bring it over here. You can see it by the box now. You guys probably already know. We'll put it by the lug nuts that my car rims got stolen out of and by the pussy right here. Bam. Not this color. This is not the right color, bro.
Ghost. It's ghost, man.
Yes, sir, man. The LeBron 15s. These were only at, like, Mall of Georgia and where else? It was another mall. It was a weird...
Cumberland,
yeah. Yep. And, bro, when I saw Lister on Instagram, which you can follow him.
Hey, one-legged Lister.
Same thing on YouTube as Instagram. I will link it all down below. He had a picture. I was like, yo, something told me he went and made that move to the mall. Was it pretty easy or?
Yeah, man, I walked right in there. Like actually, somebody hit for me on the draw up in New York. And she's like, yeah, go check, see if they're there. And I walked up in there and they were just chilling.
Wow.
They had like a full size on the, they only had an 8.5 and a 9 left.
It was just mint. So we're 8.5, 9. Is it fit big or small?
It's dead on.
Okay, cool. Size. They look great, man. Thank you once again, my brother. And yeah, these guys sold out online.
Yeah.
So
they were drawn.
And they decided to bring the price down a little bit. So you know, 185. They were, you know, what LeBron's were going for like 200 at one point, and everybody started bucking, and then finally Nike's like, we have to take the price down a little bit.
Yeah.
Man, so my man Lister about to head out. Got him right with the sock and he's on deck, along with the 2WILD tee.
Yeah.
And thank you once again for coming and bringing these boys to the. The 2WILD Mansion. We chopped it up, talked a lot about some things.
Yeah, man.
And make sure you guys check out One Legged Lister. Like I said, I will link his stuff. Look at my hair. Down below in the description. My hair was like your hair.
For yeah, you know, you got this like this yeah. emo shit. Yeah,
my hair was down. my hair is. His link is down below in the description. Go check him out. Make sure you go show some love. Let him know you came from the channel. And yeah, man, thanks once again, brother.
All right, brother.
Yep. Alright guys, so after this whole incident and whatnot, you know, I seen that there was a lot of car enthusiasts who was coming through the channel who already had came through from when I purchased the car, and I kind of thought like, maybe there's some things I need to add to this channel and whatnot, and just do everything, you know, to prevent from this happening last time, another time, I went through and just bought a couple of different things, and I don't even know if it's a smart idea, but I got a pair of the Gorilla Locks. I don't know if it's smart to show you what kind, so I'm not gonna show you. Just because maybe somebody can go buy that same kind. I don't know if these are individually made for only, like mine is totally different than anybody else's, but I got the Gorilla Locks. Let me just be smart for once and not show it, because then you guys be like, bro, somebody who's watching you, they know now what kind to buy, they're gonna go buy that one and steal your car. You know what I'm saying? Like, so I'm straight. Here I bought another tripod. Now, the reason why I bought another tripod is because basically I wanted to start shooting different angles. So if I'm shooting right here, I didn't have another tripod set up here pointing down, getting another angle. So that's just one reason I bought this tripod. This is a Viper alarm system. Basically, you know what I'm saying? You guys were telling me about this. So I went ahead and bought it. I got a person I know that can make it, that can install this for me professionally. This is the model 5706. All my car enthusiasts out there, if you know about the Viper model 5706, let me know about that down below in the comment section. This is one of the newest ones. When I last time I checked, it ran me about $200, but it doesn't really matter at this point. I want to be totally secure. You got LCD, auxiliary remote start, which I already have, and micro USB. But basically, I mean, which guys, you guys know more than me. I listen to a lot of people. I listen to people that really support what I'm doing. I listen to my subscribers and take their advice. That's why I put stuff on the internet at the end of the day, just to get you guys' advice on things. So I got this, I got the lug nuts. If there's anything smaller or else that I need to check on, I heard about this tilt system there's tilt systems that can be put alongside with this. So if I need that too, feel free to let me know. They're like $40. They basically can attach to this. But I think this is, like I said, it's a sensor. You can look it up and let me know more about that down below. But that was like the best one I've seen. Yeah, that's that. And then we got something here. I think this is from Rejuvenator. They sent some products over to basically fill up my like setup in the room. No more yellow shoes. Enjoy our new sneaker fresh bags. Oh. So these are like, basically vacuum sealed bags, and it comes with a pump. So you can basically put your sneakers in here and pump it up. I will make a video on this. I got some Rejuvenator vids I want to drop. If there's any Rejuvenator vids you would like to see, let me know down below and comment that in the comment section. We got an individual fresh bag refill, so I guess it's more of those. I'll make a video talking more about how that works, because myself, I want to know more about it. Like, I basically, though, if you're, I'll show it to you. It's a way to keep certain shoes from yellowing, basically. But yeah, guys, I mean, right now, it's, like I said, I dropped the video earlier. Hopefully you guys checked it out. Please go check it out. It's very important. You know, right now I have no car. That's one thing good about YouTube. I can work from home. I got another unboxing that I wanted to go through. I'll probably do that tomorrow. But yeah, man, I'm just kind of sitting back, relaxing, looking at things from a totally different angle. I feel kind of good about everything and how everything played out, because it made me realize a lot of things that I need to fix about my channel. And this is priorities in my life as well. Just listening to people, listening to you guys, listening to my parents, and the good and the bad. There's great criticism and there's good criticism. I'm just listening to all of it. So at the end of the day, I just want to say thank you once again for just being 100 with me, guys. And we'll be back, you know what I'm saying? Like, today was a good day, a good start. Once I find out more information about my car, they haven't even called me yet, but the car got took into the dealership yesterday. They towed it, they put it on a dolly, and they towed it off with no wheels, and it arrived to the dealership. They put it up. They haven't gave me a call yet. I'm going to call them and reach out to them and talk to them and figure out what it is. Once I find out how much everything's going to cost, I'll come back and chop it up with you guys on that and just try to give you different content, man. That's it. I mean, that's what it is. At the end of the day, we have to expand, and that's what we're going to do. But, yeah, let me know. I'll let you guys out. And it's your boy, Tony D2Wild, checking in, checking out. I love you guys. Peace.